Hello everybody, guten Tag, danke für Ihre Einladung. My talk will be in English, but as you know, in Luxembourg, we have and we need to speak several languages as we are located in a multicultural university. So, this afternoon, my aim will be to transport you to Luxembourg, of course. And if you use your imagination, we will even be transported all the way to Belval. And Belval is a new university campus located in the south of the country. On this map, you can see the capital, Luxembourg City, in the center, in red. And in the south, the country's second city, Esch-sur-Alzette, where our new Belval campus is located. And just for your information, next year, Esch-sur-Alzette will be one of the cultural city in Europe. So just for your information, if you want to come to visit it. Before the creation of the university, there was no university at all in the country of 600,000 inhabitants. And the foundation of the university was in 2003. So, as well as creating a university and giving it financial resources, the government also decided to convert an old industrial site into a 21st-century campus. Millions have been invested in the construction of thousands of buildings for learning and research, with the aim of diversifying Luxembourg's economic landscape. From the 29th century, Luxembourg, as you know probably, was an industrial country. And after that, it became a financial center. And now it is a leading player in innovation and research. On this slide, you can see the campus. And it was before, around 20 years ago, and today. So you can see the difference between the past and the current campus. I was lucky to be hired as the head of the university library in 2006. And everything had to be built. Everything had to be created from scratch. And that's how I became project manager for the construction of one of the most important buildings. And what is the most important building? Of course, the Luxembourg Learning Center. It was a luck, you know, because it was a unique experience and at the same time, an incredible challenge. Today, the university has 6,700 students with more than 129 nationalities and around 2,000 members of staff. It's an international and multilingual university. The Luxembourg Learning Center is not really a new building. In fact, it's the restoration of an industrial building previously used for storing raw materials located under the old blast furnaces. Here, you can see the building, and it was when I first saw it in 2006 during the first meeting with the architect. I remember I was there walking with the architect, and I thought, it's not possible. We cannot build a library with that. But yes, we did it. And now you can see the learning center today. So I think it's impressive to see the difference between the past and today. As Tullio said, the Luxembourg Learning Center opened its door in September 2018. And it's a vast building covering around 40,000 square meters. Of course, right in the middle of campus. It has 7 floors, 5 of which are accessible to the public. It has nearly 1,000 workspaces, 40% of which are intended for collaborative work. Here, some picture of the facade, the garden, and you can see the garden in my back, but I'm not in the garden, and the main entrance of the learning center. Today, I will share with you my thought and my experience of 12 years of project management. Know that the building has been open for 3 years. We will start our journey with a video presentation of the learning center. So I will try to open the video. One moment. It's okay, Tullio, could you confirm that you can see the image? Perfect, thank you.
Is there sound, Marie-Pierre? There is a sound. There should be a sound.
Yes, you don't have it?
No, because you have to choose an option. Alex knows, I never know exactly. View options.
Okay.
What is the option, Alex? You remember very well the
screen. Yeah, there is a tick box, include sound or something like that.
Okay, one moment.
Directly in Zoom, I guess you have to stop sharing and then start again. And then when you share for the first time, you can.
Okay, thank you. Do you have the address of the YouTube site? Oh, sorry. I stop share.
Mm-hmm.
And then start again. And it says share sound.
I don't see the option.
No, before you even click on share.
Before sharing.
Before sharing, okay.
Yeah, if you stop again, and then if you click on the share screen and you select the screen, before you click on the share button on the left, you have a little tick box.
Share sound, perfect, thank you. I see.
I always forget it.
I'm really sorry for that.
It's well hidden.
It's okay. So, let's go.
Thank you. network models are forecasting real-world behavior. Neo4j's new graph algorithms book will walk you through hands-on examples of how to use
Okay, so you had the opportunity to visit the building, so now
you want to get leaner, stronger, learn some cool calisthenics, bodyweight skills, but right now you may
So sorry for that. So you had the opportunity to visit the building. And now I would like to begin by asking you a question. Excuse me, could you hear me, or everything is okay because I don't see you anymore?
Yeah, it's okay. We see you.
Okay, sorry.
You're not sharing your slides.
Yes, yes. So it's perfect for me.
Oh, sorry. Okay, here we are.
Talk, sorry. Yes. So I would like to begin by asking you a question. Mm-hmm. In your view, what is the best architectural design for a new library building? Here you can see two possibilities: model A or model B. Of course, model A is extremely functional. It's a regular rectangle. It will be relatively easy to set up shelves, workspaces, and learning areas. One might imagine floors that are independent from one another, very practical for arranging collection of books. Model B is architecturally strong, but functionally complex. The architect took a great deal of pleasure in being creative. The Luxembourg architect of the Luxembourg Learning Center, named François Valentini, one of the most famous architects in our country, and I think in Europe or in the world, of course. And this architect, François Valentini, clearly chose model B. It was a wonderful opportunity for a library to be designed by such a creative and great architect. Today, the library has become emblematic for the university and also for the country. People come from far away to visit it, and our visitor numbers have shot up. Of course, before the COVID, after the COVID, it was more difficult to attract the user. The Luxembourg Learning Center slogan is inspiring, innovative, open. And of course, now is the place to be. I think it's a reinvention of the traditional library, and I will try to explain why. I don't think that the rectangular model would have enabled such a success. The challenge is how to reconcile architecture and functionality, or to design suitable learning spaces. Here you can see a blueprint drawn up by the project's protagonists. We were in a three-way relationship with, on the top, the architect, the technical offices, and those in charge of the interior layout. And just for your information, the interior design was done by a French company based located in Paris, and the name of this company is Ligne et Couleur. And I recommend this company if you have a project in your country. Of course, another protagonist was the authority, the government, and it was of course very important to have the budget as you know. And on the other side, the librarian, whose task was to defend the functional aspect. And in the center of our project was, of course, the users. And I will come back to that later. When we opt for a plan like Model B, there are two possibilities. Either the architect dominates the project, and you know, in some libraries project, we have to be honest, the result may look fantastic, but it isn't user-friendly or flexible. Or the architect seeks to serve the library's functional needs. If the architect is to serve the functional aspects, I see there being five challenges for the functional project manager. So I will try to share with you the several challenges for our construction. The project manager has to establish their role alongside the architect. He has to become essential in the project. He has to take the lead while remaining modest, because where one person's skills end, the next person begin. I remember the day when the acoustic office presented the plan. You know how important acoustics are in an open building. The office manager looked me in the eyes for a long time and told me that the acoustic would be perfect, that I need to trust him. And I must say that I have not been disappointed. The functional project manager has to be open-minded and able to question themselves. In reality, no question is taboo. For example, should we add an open cafeteria without walls in the middle of the shelves in a university library? At the beginning of the project, our answer was no, no. But in fact, it could have been a good idea, because the building is so attractive that we are constantly having to turn down requests to host cocktail receptions and other events. But of course, the question is more about the definition of the role of the library. But why not, if the idea is to reinvent the library? It's also important to have value and a vision, and to share this with the architect. For example, in our project, the values were openness in every sense of the term, flexibility, and diversity. We wanted to create an inspiring and very comfortable space. And finally, probably the most important point of all, dialogue. Learning spaces that are successful have inevitably been the focus of hours and hours of discussion. For example, in our project, the plan to have tables that also serve as guardrails was discussed and worked, I don't know, for maybe 10 days, just for that. User have to be placed at the center of the project, of course. And for that, we use UX design methods, user observations model, survey, etc. Our users are all different. They have different habits and needs, And that's why providing a variety of spaces, services, atmosphere, comfort levels, and colors was central to our project. I would like to come back to values, as in my view, they are essential when it comes to truly reinventing library spaces. These values have to be linked to the services we want to offer, both now and in the future, and they have to be put into practice in the spaces in conjunction with the architecture. Let me explain. Let's go back to the value of our project: openness, diversity, and flexibility. One of our values was openness. The architectural embodiment of this value, for example, is a large open space, an atrium of 6 levels, the lack of barriers, and the use of glass for the collaborative workspaces and the facade. From inside the building, users are always in contact with the outside. In terms of services, we choose to avoid banning things. Users can eat, drink, make phone calls, speak out loud, sleep, watch a film, read, play, and get some fresh air, or why not have a lunch on the outside terrace. And it goes without saying that users can borrow an unlimited number of books. We offer library service, but it goes further than that. The library is a place where users can live their lives. There is a sense of freedom. We are open for everyone, free of charge, without barriers. The building was designed to be able to open all the day and every day. Library staff members serve as guides, as intermediaries for the services on offer. And all these services and this philosophy are reflected in the choice of spaces. For example, the furniture in the welcome zone, here on the slide, you can see our welcome zone. The furniture in the welcome zone is completely open without any barriers. It could theoretically use of any of the university services. And for me, it's the reason why we can say that we are really a learning center, because other departments of the university can use the space of the all the space of the learning center. And we have some spaces for making phone calls, watching TV, having a drink, etc. Another strong concept of the project was diversity. All our users are different. They have different needs and habits. And this diversity is reflected in a wide variety of open spaces with different colors and different comfort levels. We define 6 different types of spaces: standard individual work, silent individual workspaces, individual workspaces with a computer, chill out zones, collaborative workspaces in separate rooms, collaborative workspaces in open areas. These different spaces were created in a variety of style. We also linked this to the architecture. Since the building is open to the public on different architectural levels, each level is different. We try to create reference points in the layout. For example, when exiting the lift, collaborative workspaces are always on the right and individual spaces on the left. The choice of spaces was also guided by acoustic qualities and lighting. For example, since the third floor is the quietest area, furthest from the welcome zone, we added more individual workspaces and we placed history collection there, as we know from experience that the user of this collection can sometimes be more demanding when it comes to their need for silence. Here is an example of individual workspaces a user can find in the learning center. There are a wide variety of different spaces available. And here, some examples of different types of collaborative spaces. Once again, in open space or in closed room. The variety of different spaces does not mean that there is no flexibility. Indeed, flexibility is another essential value of our project. This is reflected by the fact that all the spaces can be reconfigured. The raised floor is vital for this flexibility, but it's not the only contributing feature. None of the furniture is really fixed and everything can be moved. The plan itself is not set in stone and it can be adapted to meet changing needs. And in reality, it was really, really useful and important during the COVID crisis we faced. During the COVID crisis, it was easy to close or reduce spaces. We had the opportunity to reconfigure them. And for example, to set up a booking system in another part of the library. Our experience here in Luxembourg shows the vital importance of maintaining a dialogue between architecture and functionality and all the values of openness, diversity, and flexibility enable us to reinvent the library, creating an innovative, inspiring venue in the middle of the campus. So, thank you very much for your listening, and thank you very much for your question.